everyone. I hope you're well, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. I'm just sat listening to the waves rolling in, looking at this awesome seascape, and I'm on the Welsh coastal path. I visited a friend called Madan. Visited his family, and yesterday we were in Newquay. And this morning I woke up knowing what I wanted to do. I knew I wanted to walk. You know, I came up for a visit, but I knew I wanted to walk. So Madan has just dropped me off on the Welsh coastal path. So I'm walking from near Newquay to Aberystwyth. It'll be a one night camp. And then I've got a train ride back to Hereford. And I'm thinking of making use of that return journey because it's a month open ticket. I'm jumping off one of the stations and getting another wild camp in. It's all a healing journey. Gotta keep walking. So here I am on this amazing path, on this amazing coast, and already the vibes feel real good. Remembering Paul, obviously. That'll never stop. But I got to ascend myself, you see. It's all about ascension at the present moment. And I couldn't think of anything better than the seaside, than the coastal path. Something different. It's alive, different sounds, different smells. And it's most definitely invigorating me right now. So, all right, join me on this coastal path. We've got about 18 miles to go. We've got one wild camp, and it should be fun. Okay. Now here's a lesson for you. Too much talking. Wasn't focused on the hike, you see. And I've left my jacket in Madan's car. So I'm heading off back home all the way to Hereford via the Welsh coastal path, and I haven't got my jacket. It may rain tonight. I mean, this coast is notorious for wet weather. So if it rains, I get wet, and I've got a long journey back home with sodden clothes, if that is the case. It might be. I could text Madan and he could come and drop off my jacket at the next town, but we'll wait and see. I'll let you know later on. Bit of drama on the hike, you know. You need to be protected from the elements, don't you? And I walked off without my head, left it in the back seat. What a bugger. Yeah, I'm in Aberaeron, and besides leaving my jacket in my mate's car, I've just sent him a text and a voice message as well, so hopefully he'll pick that up. But besides that, I've got no map either. So I'm gonna have to follow this coastal path as best I can without a map, which shouldn't be too hard because, you know, all you're doing is following the coast. But you do get caught out, just like now. I walked straight into a fence and had to double back. All right, catch you later. pretty little place, Aberaeron. Just an update on where I am on the coastal path. Madan has just texted me and said that the earliest he could possibly drop off the jacket was 4 o'clock at Aberaeron. And I'm here at Aberaeron, just, well, say about half a mile outside of the town or village, beautiful little place. But yeah, what it's done, it's slowed me down. It's slowed me right down, and that's not a bad thing. What I mean by that is that, you know, I've got a two and a half hour wait here in this little town. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back shortly. I'm going to look for some stones, do a bit of beach combing, and just have a coffee or a cup of tea. And just enjoy the ambience of the town. So yeah, which is really what I needed to do, wasn't it? You know, it's just slow down and enjoy myself. So there's a silver lining in everything, really. All right. Worm. Yeah, I just thought I'd do a little stone balancing. Getting better at it. It's quite tricky. But there's loads of stones around here, so... Stones, rock. Ideal opportunity. Yeah, I'm pleased with that. There's some reasonable balances there. Wow, just look at how incredibly beautiful this late afternoon is on the Welsh coastal path. The sea is just lapping up against the shore. The sun will be setting shortly. It's warm, mild. There's not much wind. Oh, wow. Tend to pick the right time to hike. Paul and I were good at that. Today is no different. What a day. Say it's absolutely amazing walking this coastal path. I'd thought about it before, but I never really rated walking the coast. You know, I'm a bit of a landlubber. But no, this is spectacular. I'm tempted at some point, because this is only a section, to walk the whole coastal path. You know, because it's going to take you through Snowdonia, you know, starting in Pembrokeshire. So you're going to pass through some pretty awesome landscape. And if it's like this, well, brilliant. Which it won't be. The weather will vary. But yeah, I recommend it to anyone. Absolutely fantastic. I've got some chips, a jumbo sausage, and the most meagre carton of curry sauce I've ever received. I'm beside this church in Llanon, which is right on the coastal path. The reason it's late and the reason it's dark is because I met this wonderful woman, young woman, called Hannah. And we had this most amazing conversation on the coastal path about life, about her father who died, about Paul, about sliding doors, you know, the cosmic nature of life, about books, about writing, ambition, you know, what our visions for the future. And by the time we finished, it was dark. And so I got some chips and I'm in the town, you see. And there's not an obvious place to pitch. So I headed for this church, thinking it might be open, but it's not. The only other option right now is to head for this wooden pavilion. So I'm going to eat these chips. Not sure that whether that was focused or not, guys, but I'm going to eat these chips and then try and locate this pavilion. So I'll catch you later when I locate a place to doss or get me head down. All right, it's a bit of a urban stealth camp. All right.
Yep. That was nice. Thank you.
should I say, morning. No, it feels like morning. It was a very pleasant little village, Clannon, which is where I'm camped right now. I'm actually camped on a football pitch. It's the only place I could find last night after chatting to Hannah. And later on, two really nice young boys came to talk. They'd actually guided me here and came to check on me later to see if I'd found it. And the one young boy, Tom, had lost his mum 6 years ago at the age of 10. And the other, Harry, had lost his uncle. And then there was Hannah, who had lost her father. So Clannon has been somewhat of a journey of commiseration and sympathy and empathy. It's very pleasant talking to them all. And of course, I shared with them my experience with Paul. But yeah, I feel very relaxed here. I'm looking at the sea, which is out there in yonder. It's a bit blowy, but nothing much. And I'm just enjoying the warmth. I'm quite comfortable. It's about 6:45 in the morning, and I'll pack up shortly and get walking. But yeah, very pleasant time in Llanon, on the west coast of Wales. I just still feel battered about by Paul. I mean, you know, he's my twin, 48 years. I just said to myself now, it's hard to believe that, say, in 3-4 years' time, that this pain will dissipate, will have dissipated, but it will, I know, because there are little signs that it is dissipating. But right now, still very hard. But this is why I'm out walking, this is why I'm out hiking, you know, to find and tap into life again. All right, there's reasons to be joyful. So with that in mind, I'll say cheerio for now and catch you up. All right, catch you up on the trail. Well, we're off, back on the path. Try and pick it up at least. I've got no map. So we may come across a few dead ends, but in the main, we're just following the coast. It's, you know, it's quite a fresh morning. It's beautiful. It's not particularly windy, there's only a breeze. Yeah, beautiful. Oh, look at this beautiful enclave. Hey? Why?
beautiful vases.
Brigidion.
Beautiful little enclave. I love walking through places like this. It takes you back. Back to a stiller time. Quieter time. And there was a quieter time. Oh, we're back on the path. That was very easy. That's the thing with not having a map. You're forced to reach out, ask local people. I just asked two guys back there who were loading a van where the coastal path was, and they directed me this way. So yeah, not having a map, it's not right for all occasions, but it's okay for this one. It's a pretty good thing. All right, forward.
There you go. Done my job. Concealed the waste. And relieved for the day. Nature calls.
That was amazing. I just met Daniela, a Swiss girl. She's hiking part of the coastal path. Lovely girl, full of life, very kind. And she's on a kind of a healing walk too. Her partner just broken up with her. So yeah, we're all out here, aren't we? Trying to find our way. But the strangest thing is, she's a book writer. She writes books. And I met Hannah last night, who's a book writer, and I'm writing a book. So, you know, what's being said here? I've got to carry on and commit myself to this project. Which, you know, is going to take me into all manner of places. All right, that was a wonderful meeting. Gorgeous, eh? Any beauty?
That's the thing about not using a map again. I've just spoken to some wonderful people in the farmhouse there, and they've guided me the way to get back on the coastal path. So yeah, it's an easy route, you know, the coast, but you run into dead ends. Without a map, that is. So I'm kind of back on track now.
It's fruit and nut mix. A reasonable ready-made trail mix. Just add a bit of water and a few nuts and a bit of fruit, and ready for the next few mile up that hill, I think.
Going to be walking this range of the west coast of Wales in the mist today. I love it. It's mystical, it's magical, mythical. You can't see much, you know, thick drizzle, but it's really refreshing, and it's a prime time to be out. Wonderful. Losing my way just for a moment and pick the trail back up. Can't really see much. Brief confab on the gate. That's a bit of a reprieve from the driving drizzle on top there. At least we can see a bit of the sea. Oh. Yeah, what a joy. What a joy. All credit to my brother. Blinding. I've lost the coastal path again, but I'm heading for this ridgeline, and I'm just going to walk it into Aberystwyth, because I can see Aberystwyth from where I am now. Let's go and have a look at these layers. Look at this. Can't pass up a chance to look at this, can you? Wow. All this compacted sediment. Millions of years of just organic life, just huge forces just pressing them down. And then I think tectonic plates pushing them up, you know, because they're at an angle. I mean, I'm no geologist, so I've probably got that wrong, but... And if I have, please do correct me. But yeah, awesome. Awesome geological wonders on this coast walk. Beautiful sight, that's Aberystwyth. I've come to the end of my hike from near Newquay to Aberystwyth. I'm not sure how many miles that is. A one night camp in Llanon, which was great. I met a wonderful girl, a young woman, Hannah, and two young lads, Tom and Harry. And coming through the cliffs there, wow, that was fantastic. So I'm going to walk into Aberystwyth now. I'm going to find a place to sit down, have a cup of tea, cup of coffee, and later on find a place to get my head down. If you liked it, please do like. If you've got any comments, I look forward to your thoughts. And if you'd like to subscribe, I look forward to your company. That was a great hike. I'll see you again. Take care, guys. Peace.